I like that red. I'm painting my studio again. I started off with the triangle here. And the base of the blue triangle, it's two-thirds the length of the wall. And I painted this whole blue triangle already. It's on the wall over there. You can't see it, but it's beautiful. But it took a really long time. You see, I didn't do it in the most efficient way possible. You see, I bought 1 pint of blue paint because I didn't know how much I'd need. And I painted a little bit of the triangle. I needed more. I went back to the store, bought another pint, came back, painted a little bit more. And back and forth, each time I needed a new pint, I went and bought another one. That's a ridiculous way to buy paint, so I don't want to do that for the red triangles. I want to just go to the store once and get the right amount of paint. Now, it took me 6 pints of paint to paint the blue triangle. How many pints of paint do I need to paint the 2 red triangles? And it's basically an area problem. If the red area, if the total red area is the same as the blue area, then I need 6 pints of red paint, because I need 6 pints of blue paint for this. If the red area is double the blue area, then I need 12 pints. If it's triple the area, I need 18 pints, and so on. So I need to compare the area of the red regions to the area of the blue region. But I don't know the area of the blue region. And I guess I could measure the bottom, measure the height here, but I don't feel like finding a ruler. Can't we figure this out without measuring anything? That sounds like work, and we don't want to do that. I don't know the height of the wall or the length here, but we can use variables for that. They're unknown, so we can just stick in variables. I'll call the height y, and I could call the length, the base here, x, but this is 2/3 of the length, and this is 1/3 of the length. Then I've got fractions, and we avoid fractions when we can. Instead of calling the whole thing x, I'm just going to call this piece right here x. And then this is 1/3 of the length of the bottom here. This is 2/3, so this, the base of the blue triangle, is double the base of the red triangle. So we can just call that 2x, and look, no fractions. That's nice. And if this is y, that means this over here is y as well. So now we can find the area of the blue triangle in terms of x and y. Base here is 2x. The height from this vertex, the altitude there, is y. So we know that the area of the blue triangle, the blue, is 1/2 of 2x times y. 1/2 cancels with the 2, of course. And the area of the blue region is just xy. Now we'll do the small red triangle. That's a right triangle. So the small red, the legs are x and y, so its area is just 1/2 x times y. So the small red triangle is just half the area of the blue triangle. So if the blue is 6 pints, then the small red must require 3 pints. Now we move on to the large red triangle. That's also a right triangle, and we know the lengths of its legs. This one's y, and this one is the same as this whole length. The bottom of the wall is the same as the top of the wall, so that's 3x. So the area here is 1/2 y times 3x. And that's equal to 3/2 xy. So the amount of paint I need for this triangle is just 3/2 the amount I needed for the blue triangle. Or I could look at it as the large red triangle is 3 times the size of the small red triangle. I need 3 pints for the small triangle, so I need 9 pints for the large one. So in total, I need 3 plus 9, I need 12 pints of red paint. And I'm done, and I'm gonna go get some paint. Hey, wait a second. The blue triangle has twice the area of the red triangle. The base of the blue triangle is double the base of the red triangle. We know that because this is 2/3 of the wall, this is 1/3 of the wall, so this is double that. The altitudes from this vertex are the same for both triangles. The altitude from here to this base extended of the blue is just this segment right here. And that's obviously also the altitude from this vertex in the little right triangle, the little red right triangle. They have the same altitude. the base of the blue triangle is double the base of the red triangle. They have the same altitude. That means the area of the blue triangle is twice the area of the red triangle. We didn't need all this algebra to tell us that. We could have just thought about how area of the triangles work. We have the same altitude. The base of the blue is double the base of the red. So the area of the blue is double the area of the red. So we could have gone immediately from 6 pints to 3 pints. And then this triangle up here is the same as these two triangles put together. We have a rectangle divided by a diagonal. This whole triangle in total requires 9 pints. So we know that this whole triangle will also require 9 pints. So we didn't need all that algebra at all. I mean, algebra is nice. Algebra is nice. You can solve a lot of problems with algebra, but don't always just jump right into the algebra as fast as you can. Keep an eye out for a more clever solution.